Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. This is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, saints of God. Good morning, faith-based community. Good morning, True Vision Church. And good morning, those prayer warriors that are out there that join us daily to pray, intercede on behalf of others. Welcome to our prayer time together. As a matter of fact, I'm so glad that you are here. My name is Elder Corey Mobley. I'm joining you from True Vision Church here, located here in San Antonio, Texas. Our pastor is Pastor Michael Steve Brown, and we are continuing to celebrate his 25 years of being our pastor. Do me a favor right now. Like this video, share this video, comment during this time together, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and like our Facebook page. But do not stop there. Type in your I am statement. I'm blessed. I'm glad to be here. I'm highly favored. Or I'm tired. I don't want to be here. I'm frustrated. Whatever your I am statement. But don't stop there. Take some time. Take a moment and boast on God. Name one thing that God has done for you on today. Again, we're gathered here today to read scripture from our devotional book, God's Way, Day by Day. God's Way, Day by Day. But not only that, we're going to read scripture, we're going to let it meditate, we're going to meditate on it, but then we're going to pray about it. Today's devotional topic is God's Children. God's Children is coming from the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 16 and 17. Verse 16 and 17. New King James rendering of the text says this: the Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. God's children, that's what we are. We are God's children. Let's pray together. Oh God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. God, the one that sits high but looks low. God, the great creator of heaven and earth. God, the author and finisher of our faith. God, the wheel in the middle of the wheel. God, my meat and bread when I'm hungry. God, my water when I am thirsty. God, my Father in heaven. Lord, we are your children. And so we thank you for being a good father. The kind of father that provides protection. The kind of father that provides nurturing when we need it. You provide for us. You keep us. You hold us together. You ease our burdens, lighten our heavy loads. You are the kind of father that loves us beyond measure. Thank you, God. Lord, as your children, you're always ever guiding us. You're walking with us and talking with us. And you're reminding us that you love us unconditionally. Lord, if there's anyone in the sound of my voice or beyond the sound of my voice that does not see themselves as one of your heirs to the kingdom, I ask you to touch them and keep them and hold them together, remind them that everything is okay, that you do love them, that they are your chosen, that you have a sure future planned for each one of them. Let them receive that today. Lord, as we are children of God, we lift up our pastor's children today as we are praying for him and his family during this 25-year celebration month. God, we ask you to touch Michael and Angelo, protect them, keep them, remind them that everything's okay. Lord, when they feel that they should not have to share their father so much with so many different people, remind them that it's okay, that their father has been equipped with the ability to father them, to love on them the measure that they need. But not only that, he's been equipped to guide this church as well. Lord, whenever Michael and Angelo go through situations that life brings, remind them that they are of the anointed family. Yes, they are. They're of, and that there's a special measure from God for them, that everything's going to be okay. Lord, I ask you to touch them and let them know that they are important, that they are part of the number one fan club of their father, that they are the number one to lift him up, to make him feel appreciated, that they're the number one group to make him feel loved. Lord, we thank you for the children of our pastor, Pastor Michael Steve Brown, as we ask you to watch over them in a special way today. Lord, thank you for being our Father once again, the kind of Father that looks beyond our faults and takes care of our needs. Thank you for that. It's in Jesus' name we pray today, our soon coming King. Hallelujah and amen. All right. Thank you, Living Church. Thank you for praying with us today. Thank you for praying for our first family. We ask you to continue to lift up our pastor during this month, and he celebrates his 25 years of being our pastor. Until we see you again on tomorrow to close out this week in good high fashion, God bless you. God keep you. Bye-bye.
So I started singing.
Listen, it says,
I've had my share of ups and downs, times when there was no one around. God came and spoke these words to me.
Praise
me. Will confuse the air.
So I started singing.
I started dancing.
People were laughing.
People were laughing.
Cause they knew my problems.
They knew